Welcome to Daily Thoughts for August 22nd on peaceworkstv. I'm Stephen Jarnik, and the title of today's thought is The Light of the World. We can read about that in Matthew chapter 5, verses 14 to 16. This is actually a continuation of yesterday's thought, where we took a look at Jesus telling us to be the salt of the earth. Both of these passages are taken from Jesus' Sermon on the Mount, and in my Bible, they're sort of lumped together in a section called Salt and Light. You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on a stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. This is kind of a strange one because in some ways it seems like it's the complete opposite of what Jesus teaches in other sections of the Bible. He talks about not letting your left hand know what your right hand is doing. Basically means not to make a big show out of doing good deeds because God will know and it doesn't really matter what anyone else thinks. So how do we reconcile these two ideas that appear to be complete opposites? I think it comes down to the orientation of our hearts. If we're doing good deeds because we want people to notice how wonderful we are, that's not a good thing. If, however, we're humble and make it clear that it's not about us, it's just God working through us to help others, that's a different story. People need to see that because then it's clear that it's all about God and He's the one that should be praised. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we want to be the light in the world, your light in the world. Please help us to not become arrogant and self-centered as we do your work, but instead to be good role models of what it looks like when you work through your people. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.